What is going on, YouTube? It's John from Emphatic coming to you with the latest Emphatic War recap. 82-79 victory over Crystal Warrior, midweek war. Don't recall the breakdown on this, actually. One second. Okay, so this was a 5-11-14 breakdown. We ended up getting a 10v10. They did not. Got 74% on their Town Hall 9s. They got 48. And then we had a couple dip fails. We had the same amount, basically. So that kind of sucked. I was one of them. Trying to get the dragon attack down. And, yeah, this probably wasn't the best war to try to keep doing that in. But, you know, it happens. And, yeah, we did decent on 10v11, too. Five hits for... or five bases we took down in 12 hits, so it's better than what we've been seeing. They could not get two of ours. In fact, they went for an 11v11. No, they did not go for 11v11. Who knows? I don't know. Okay. Well, we are on their side, so let's see what the percentages were. Mr. Free is 56, 52, 53, 58, 54. So nothing really worth showing there. The 10v10 we got was just a really weak base, and In and Out just came and smashed it. And it's kind of what you're going to be looking to do with these 91s that you're going to be seeing. I mean, granted, this is going to be past the 91 because, you know what, this one might still be stuck at, like, 91, just, well, because of the heroes, but the rest of the base, you know, and they had Dragon CC as well, so... Queen can easily go right in. He's taking a sweet time on getting that poison out. But we drop a bunch of bowlers. Both Infernals are in the same compartment, too, so this is a total midweek base. Oh, hits the double, so those bowlers all got to be gone, but Kane is in there to almost get the enemy Kane. Queen hops the fence. She's going to take out a couple more buildings. Will she get that other expo? That is the question. Looks like she's locked onto it, and it is done. And nice little entry there for a 40% kill squad. Got a bowler out that's going and starting some early cleanup, so he will be sending in a Lalo now. Because we have... Well, actually, that's a one ground expo, so... But these are all level 2, so... I think that's the color for level 2. It's been a while since I've seen a level 2 expo, even though I just had a Town Hall 10 that got up to level 3. Which, on the Town Hall 10 front, that base is now a 40-40 heroes. So I just put the cane down today. You know, the last four levels I farmed up with at least 2 days to go on the cane, the build. I haven't been jamming it at all, just not even needing the cane to the farm. And got all my Dark Elixir with 2 days left on the builder, so maybe I'll pop over and show a couple of those. Maybe we could talk about the tier 1, too. I don't know. I think my clan mostly gets it, but it can always help. Nice hit In and Out. Exploiting a weak base. I think we had some pretty good percentages, too. We probably aren't showing them anymore. Yeah, we're not showing. It looks like the 11s just went over and hit whatever. They didn't go for low percent. This war had to be some Rudex, too, because Rudex, congratulations, produced a little barbarian, and he says Archer Queen is doing fine, so congratulations, buddy. I think he is back in the game already now, so he can't keep Rudex down for long. He's got to be busy destroying everybody in the farming race, which was kind of funny when I was on there. He only had, like, a 1 million gold, and that was it. I think he had a builder not active, too, so he was really dropping the ball there. Must have had something else important going on. Alrighty, so Queen is going to walk. I don't know how many nines I'm going to show, to tell you the truth. This is a straight-up 9, right? Yeah, 33's got to... We got so many new people right now, it's hard for me to keep up. Kind of glad I'm not leader, because I'd feel bad. And these wall breakers split bad on him, too, but it looks like both affected a wall, so next set should go to a spot that he needs, especially if he takes out that cannon first. He might be waiting for that cannon to go down. No, he deploys, gets him in the right spot. They go through the rage, too, so they're breaking whatever wall they wanted. They're going to get two layers broken, so and that's a nice little idea when you're raiding here, 10, 11, whatever. Overload the wall breaker, especially if you don't see splash there. Get a double wall break. Take advantage of a deeper push, especially at Town Hall 10. If you're going to bowl Lalo, and you get a little bit of a deeper push or wall break in there and push your jump one compartment deeper, those bowlers are 60% kill squad easy. Makes it real easy for whatever's on the back end. Hell, you might even get a second Inferno. I know that was something I noticed when they first nerfed miners and everybody had to go back to hogs. It was however deep you can get those bowlers in there. And then everybody went away from the 9x9 outside compartments. So you had to... And went with Hound CCs, so you pretty much were stuck doing a suicide hero. That's not absolutely a terrible way, at least for Queen. When you know it's a Hound CC to just do the Sui Queen. Unless you can walk her and make sure that the Hound is always kept busy. Kind of looking forward to getting back into some 10v10 a little bit. I've been, actually I'm hoping I can get back into 10v10. I kind of really hate the 10v11 game. But just got, along with getting the 40-40 heroes on Sloppy, I just got the level 3 miners and I have the heal down. So by CW All-Star, I will definitely be a lethal to low bases Town Hall 10. And only a 92 too, so definitely some value in that account. I think that account's going to stay a lifetime 92 for as long as they don't change the rules on me like they did for the 91. Might have to bounce out and put one of my bases up for Batman. I don't think I've shown JJD in a while. So here you go, buddy. Doing what JJD does. Gonna swag the Ice Whiz, but doing the leave the Queen alone and just skelly the crap out of her. Queen walk. I don't know if I see him Queen walk often with this attack. I don't know. Maybe this will be something I play with when I get to back to my Town Hall 9, since I burned everybody's eyes. It was nice waking up to the social chat in our Discord server after putting up the Science of the Witch set video, but since I went and burned everybody's eyes, I guess I could figure out some other attacks. I know I have some requests to do 10v10 attacks strategies on there as well. Unfortunately, I'm not the best 10v10 guy, but I was a pretty snazzy miner guy when they were OP, so maybe I can pick that back up on our babies. Unfortunately, Sloppy Second's going to be a repository for low-level Town Hall 10 bases, so I kind of don't want to go on there and just FC the crap out of me and burn them all. Because then that's more work I have to do. I've already got 2 out of 4 slots filled up that I want to... That's my goal to fill up, being a... one of the primary base builders. You know, we got a couple guys that are just cranking out some bases right now, getting them ready. Which is really what you got to do in this league. You got to get prepared, and we're desperately trying to test and see what we can do to combat these miners, but I have a feeling it's not 100% possible. You can make it tough and make them burn a couple attacks, but eventually they are going to get you, I think. You know, as long as a clan doesn't sink all their hits into Town Hall 10v11, they should at least get a couple 10v10s just by minoring your 92 and below. I think we're supposed to carry a 92 in war at least. Maybe 2 92s in Invite League, so everybody should at least have 2 10v10s. We got our, a little bit more of a 10v10 squad now, a little bit more of a confirmed one than we did last season as well, so that's really a welcome change. With In and Out joining the group, we got Vortex, RM, AW, maybe me, I hope, I pray, please, I don't know, we'll see. We got a, We gotta see how 10v11 shakes out. I mean, I've got all but one archer tower either done or down. Did Eve witch slap for me again? Did I didn't show any of these, did I? I don't think I showed any attacks. Wait, number 23, this looks like a. Yeah, this is one I already showed. No, we can't double play her. Sorry. But of course, Eve did the fresh six pack with the witch slap. Using the science of the witch slap methods, and I believe you saw post coach vids on there. Nice little troll here for a queen. And Master RK, I've heard, has been doing this P.E.K.K.A. attack, and this is might be my first time seeing it. But he's got a single P.E.K.K.A. in there. I'll have to see what he's gonna do with it. I don't think he's doing the. Well, no, he's obviously not doing the Groninator because he got 15. I don't even remember what the Groninator is anymore, honest, to be honest. I know it was like the big OP attack, and I just don't remember it whatsoever. Mean, did the P.E.K.K.As go through and beat through the walls and push through the entire base and with some bowlers behind? I don't remember. Could look up some old school brutal raids and see. Of course, we have a healer that decided to go get herself killed. Following that hog that got the lure, which a smart idea, still luring. I might be looking at some queen walks here too in the near future, especially because laptop just unlocked, got the level 5s unlocked, finished out of the lab. So this is a little slow of a start, but really curious to see if a queen walk can be added to punish these stupid cancer bases. But of course, I have to build the anti-2s. So Queen's gonna pretty much lose her healers now. So not quite sure. Kane and P.E.K.K.A. is walking around. And this is a really slow attack. There we go. Here comes some hogs. Queen's already popped the ability, so Queen's just gonna die. So I don't know if her job was just to build a funnel, but Town Hall 9 attacks, it just feels like your queen should survive. Or everything you can do to keep her alive. We send in some level 7 hogs. We got two heals and a rage, so he does have this base pretty wrecked. It's just a really slow one. Got a max skeleton he can use. And he can rage to the very end there if he wants. Probably rage the balloons through, I don't know. Drops the skeleton, drop the rage. Rages the skellies. This one's kind of a wacky attack, I think. But he gets the job done. Have to see how much time this took, because it was a slow start. Let's just see real fast. So he basically had 1 second left. This guy was expecting to get witch slapped if he saw the signs of the witch slap video. That's a painful hit there, although he's kind of short on bombs to take out witches. Alright, so nailed or beat a buzzer beater there. Who have I not shown in a while? Kevin got a six pack, it looks like. Miller I've shown, Mr. Master I've shown. You know what? Mr. Master always gets upset when I don't show him, and he's been working on some kind of new OP attack that's not Witch Slap, because Witch Slap is bad. Does not look like this is it, though. It looks like it could be a Quad La Loon. Probably a Sui Hero. Maybe. I don't know. He's got two skeleton spells, so it's quite possible. Some balloons funnel. They're gonna go down. Queen and Kane are gonna take out all of these wizard towers and pretty much negate the sweeper, so that's a really good call. I think. And then he just lolos the back half pretty much. So, this is superb base building. 101. Queen pops her Billy. She's gonna go get that. No, she's not gonna go with the fourth header. She is gonna deal with the clan castle and probably lose this battle. Yeah, I don't know if so we get a rage poison down. It's kinda the baby dragon will die to that level 5 poison. As long as he stays in, it looks like he is gonna go down. Wizards are running out all over the place. Well, Pup mercifully takes it down. You know, poison and skeletons on the queen, maybe. Level 1 skellies, that's kind of a big risk there. I don't know why I just sped it up there. But there is the sweepers in play. He's got still plenty of rages there, just barely catches a minute. But enough that they're going to stay hasted up. And some red bombs almost tank this raid here. We only got one balloon left with the hounds. We lose a bunch of pups. And with a balloon drop, we get it. Wow. That is a very tight raid. It's a total TH9 hit. Nice hit, Vic. Wow. Alright, I think I'm going to call it quits on that one. You know, little 30s are just not much, especially without having that much 10 and 11 action to show. So, yeah, that's about all I got. You guys, thanks for watching.